Scorpio, you wanna see what's up? What do we have for Scorpio's highest good? I did. I wanted to see what was up.
Oh, hey! Hey! None of that on my watch, Scorpio. Hell no. Hang on a second. Now, I've had a song stuck in my head prior to recording this, and I don't remember the artist or something like that, but... Listen. I'm going to read these cards to you in just 2 seconds, but let me just tell you this little story about this little song I got stuck in my head.
Okay, I have questions for you, Scorpio. You know what? Can you, call me.
It's that little hip-hop country song. It's like, take me to the country, show me where you're from. I said, Shawty, you're gonna love me and we're gonna have some fun just a little bit.
Why are you doubting? Why are you limiting your beliefs on love? Why are you... Okay, I know why. I'm asking why. That's the gist. And then you got this, like you're happy, like just moving on in shame. Well, shame to whoever makes you feel like some limiting beliefs on relationships and love. Even like being friends with. I'm hearing even being friends with this little shake. Outpouring of love. Yeah. That's what they don't tell you about not having limiting beliefs. Shawty, they gonna love you. All right, let me ask specific. Why'd they wait for shame? It's God, they're moving on with a kid, too. That is somebody else's gold, trust me. You, like, things that, That switched it. Ooh. There's too much traffic in your mind, Scorpio, when it comes to this. Like, seriously, even there's even helicopters going, where's the blockage? I don't really see anything in my nose. I gotta stop watching old movies. Guys, I'm an impressionist. If you have not figured that out yet by now, what you gonna do with your talent? Keep it real close, because it's my entertainment, too. Anyhow. Okay, so, what are you so ashamed about? You know how people are like, some people can be like, man, I'm trying so hard not to use definitives, guys. But it's so rampant outside of me that, you know, we can't help but, no wonder we're all like, by each other, you know, and I can't say that, because that's a good definitive, you know, maybe. Scorpio, your energy is all or nothing, right? Which is kind of interesting, because the world is not all or nothing. And I got me a strong Scorpio placement, so I understand what you mean. Why the method to the madness? It's not mad. It's actually quite contained and understandable, so right on. But there's this feeling of shame, but you don't care, nor should you. Maybe it's because it's out in the open. Good. Now, if you're having issues because of, man, sometimes the 8 can insinuate that we are responsible for our limiting beliefs. Just intuitively knowing that when we are born, we are not inherently like, I don't know, that doesn't seem right, you know. I mean, in certain situations, I'm just saying we don't see shame yet. We don't feel shame. We don't, like, right? I mean, we just come to these conclusions. I remember when I did something bad. According to who? If necessary. I'm working on my grammar.
I've been working on my grammar. Anywho, who doesn't love English? Or at least just proper speaking. I have fun with it either way. So. So, okay, the vibe I'm getting from this six. How you doing? You're getting back on track, but it's with this sense of like, you're moving on from, Lindsay got assumption. Sorry about the way I said that. It's almost like, yeah, no, don't be worried. You said it nicer. So somebody here has left a limited thought process relationship. They are single now, and they are getting back on track by moving forward, and there's no obstacles. Here's the thing. Scorpio, you're headed home. Aquí. Okay? Not like out a key. There's shame in feeling like nothing's gonna stop me now. Unless you're met by an equal and opposite force.
For every action, that is an equal and opposite reaction.
Yeah, you got that right. Hey, at least if so, let's say here. Okay. What's this opposing force?
I know. It doesn't have a good grip, that's for sure.
The opposing force doesn't have a good grip. Where you've taken a risk, some other force is taking a risk. And it seems reckless.
Yeah, what's reckless? I feel like the category has truly stretched itself wicked thin here.
Oh. You should have told Scorpio then. You should have told him. I love it. I think my favorite part of life right now is figuring out that people do not say what they mean, what they say, and they don't say it nicely. So, I mean, or be like, I gotta figure myself out. Sometimes people have to figure themselves out, and now we're not able to say that because it's like, oh, the usual gist. I gotta find myself. Da, da, da. Well, maybe that's what's up. I really don't know how it is around the world, but I do know that it feels like we're all in this together. So, what I am thinking to myself right now is, I'm being given a scenario, like a way to see it. So, I've been asked to make it personal. I'd love to. I'm a little bit of a bitch when it comes to being scared. It's thrilling, but scary. And when I feel intimidated by something around me, especially when it's all done in play, I'll get loud right back. But still enjoy the process. But I'll get like angry mad or angry loud. Like I'll be like, ah! So one of the things that I absolutely love doing is doing like I love horror stuff, but it still scares the crap out of me. But if somebody is doing something and they're just doing their job, you know, like say I'm in a I gotta give an actual example. Wow, I need to get out more. there'll be a situation where someone will be an actor or something at a haunted house, and if someone gets in, if someone gets in my face and gets me, I will be like, rah! Right back. But I'll be like, okay, let's go again. You know, like, like, you got me. Oh my gosh. There are stories. If you scare me, I will bite back. And in those instances, it's all good. So there's a chance that you figuring out who you are and moving on and not almost having like the appearance of shame and guilt. Oh my God, Scorpio, I can totally relate to you. I got that heavy Scorpio placement. Eventually, we're going to have to talk about those things because it's like, well, you were really scared, Scorpio. I had to act somehow. I had to, otherwise, there's another block. And so maybe there is a beneficial things to acting when it comes to real life. And people are genuinely going to some. Is this multiple people? Scorpio, the truth is you're moving on, and people's reaction is going to be kind of sad. They're going to be like, why though? Like, why? And you're like, well, because there's a great big world out there, Barnaby. I won't come back until you've kissed a girl. Lofty goals. Lofty goals. Tall order. Yeah. Scorpio, somebody doesn't want to see you move on. You're not moving on. You're just doing you. And because if you go, technically, they're there. You know what I mean? Like, risk-taking can literally come in the form of leaving your hometown. Risk-taking can literally come in the form of being friends with someone that other people's limiting beliefs or your own makes it difficult to have that relationship. It's so stupid. But at the same time, we can fake it till we make it out. Now I get it. Scorpio's like, you're telling me things I already know? Well, then, you know, your sister Gemini over here just got it, and she'd like to talk to you about it, so. And thank you guides for that, because honestly, these, my guides are the coolest. Aren't yours? Like, some of the funniest guides. I feel like it was a requirement whenever I did my, apparently we chose to be here and chose what we chose and chose. I bet we have trouble with that when we don't have close relationships. It's like, I chose that man. Yeah, you chose it so that you would learn this. I see. Oh my gosh, there was this amazing, I think it was a TikTok. I get so confused. I think everybody does. I don't know what platform I saw it on. What's his name? Sheldon from The Big Bang Theory? He's looking over a contract, but it's been kind of edited to where it's like, me looking over my soul contract. It's got Sheldon, like, flipping through, and he's like, why? Why? And he flips again, and he's like, oh, that's why. It's kind of like that. And allow me to remind you that we're going through a huge astrological reset. Now, because we don't take change well, it's gonna be like 20 years long, and you know, at the end of this year it starts, like November-ish, December. I think it's like the very last day of December. We start a 20-year transit to where Aquarius takes over in, what does it take over in? Aquarius is taking over, period. That's all you need to know. And Aquarius is,
hopes, dreams, connections, friends, that's the transition, you know? Pardon. And it looks like you got the gist. Yay, Scorpio understood the assignment. All right, I've lectured you enough. I love you. Talk to you soon. Bye.